Greetings, kiddos. I'm Dark-Minded Sith. One thing I just want to throw very quickly at the beginning of this video is that this is probably going to be the last Q&A video that I do for maybe about a week or something like that. I'm not done with it yet, but this Q&A thing is actually taking a little bit longer than I thought it would. I thought with 25 to 30 minute videos each part, I thought I would get done with this relatively quickly, but it turns out it's taking a little bit longer than I thought, and I don't want to just keep making Q&A videos for like 2 or 3 weeks. You know, I feel like people just really want to see Majora's Mask, so, and I kind of want to do that too, so. I'm probably going to go ahead and just do this Q&A video, which is like part 5, and then I'm probably going to take a break for like a week or so, and just stick to Majora's Mask for a good solid week, and then eventually get back to the Q&A stuff, so. Yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know that that was the agenda for the next week or two. So, anyway, let's get on with your beautiful questions. Answer the Ryan9169 asks, "Where's Waldo?" I ate him. Let's see. CrazyGamer53 asks, "Have you ever played Minecraft?" People insist that I play it, but I just haven't got around to trying it yet. Not because I'm not interested in it or anything, but I just haven't got around to it personally. Beautiful Glenn asks, "What is my favorite cake?" Probably carrot cake, actually. I really love carrot cake. Insanity96 asks, "What is my favorite of the Disney animated classics?" Probably Lion King. I'm a sucker for that movie. It was my childhood one, so I gotta go with that. Do you like the Rayman games? I absolutely love Rayman 2. Love it to death, but that's the only Rayman game I've played. Alright, DBC6060 asks, "What is your favorite video game soundtrack, song, music, etc.? All that jazz and blues." It's hard for me to pick, like, just one specific track, but when it comes to soundtracks, I'd probably say the ones that stand out the most to me are all the Zelda soundtracks and all the Final Fantasy soundtracks. It'd be really hard to pick, like, specific tracks from those, but just random ones at the top of my head. Like, I always love the Zelda Overworld themes. My favorite would have to be Termina Field. Love Dragon Roost Island, Midna's Lament, or also known as Midna's Desperate Hour. Telltale Heights stands out. The Dark World, Song of Healing, Oath to Order, Lost Woods, slash Saria's Song. Those are probably the big ones that stand out for Zelda. And then Final Fantasy, God, that goes on forever. You know, You're Not Alone. Just a lot of the opening themes for all those. The victory theme. Yeah, just in terms of just soundtracks, I'd probably say Zelda and Final Fantasy. There's all kind of random tracks here and there that I love from different games, but mostly those two games. What is your favorite Banjo-Kazooie and Tui character? I guess it'd be typical to just say Banjo and Kazooie, but I guess in terms of like a side character, maybe Lago the Toilet. Let's go with Lago the Toilet. Meaner Toad asks, "Which country do you think is the best?" I can't really answer that. I can't really give a legitimate answer to that because I don't know enough about every country on the planet, but I guess at the top of my head, I don't really know what you would what would be considered best, but at the top of my head, I guess maybe Japan, possibly. They seem to be the best at pretty much everything. I don't know. Griffwitch asks, "Have you met any light-minded Siths?" There's been a few here and there, a few a few homeless guys I've ran into here and there who want to, like, rake my leaves, and they're pretty light-minded, I'd say. Second question, do you have in your possession any hats of any interesting nature? Yeah, I do, actually, and I'll show those now. Pretty interesting, if you ask me. Alright, Scottman895 asks, out of all the Mario Party games you've played, what is your favorite Mario Party board? The only two Mario Party games I know really well are 1 and 2. I've played like 3, 4, and probably up to about maybe 6 or 7, but I really don't remember those boards all that much. I just really remember the ones from 1 and 2. My favorite out of those, probably, oddly enough, probably Pirate Land. It's kind of an odd answer. People seem to really like Horror Land and Mario's Rainbow Castle and stuff like that. I don't know. I guess it's sort of the beach stuff, piratey stuff. I don't know. Second question: which of the following video game birds is the most annoying to you? Canary Mary, Kazooie, or Kapora Gabora? I don't really know why Kazooie's thrown in there, because I don't really find Kazooie to be annoying. I probably got to go with Canary Mary on that one, because all she does is cause pain, basically. Kapora Gabora, as much as we hate him, he does at least help you a little bit. So, Canary Mary just causes pain, basically, mostly towards your thumbs. TurkeyLeg987 answered that one, but what was your favorite NES game? I'd probably say Mario 3. Gotta go with Mario 3. JetDude77 asks, who is your favorite YouTuber? Well, I mostly watch Let's Plays. I can't really say what my favorite Let's Player is. If you want to know, like, favorite YouTuber who doesn't do Let's Plays, just a random YouTuber, I'd say probably either Red Letter Media or maybe The Archfiend. Probably one of those two guys. I watch the Archfiend more on a regular basis, but that's just because he updates all the time. Red Letter Media doesn't do stuff all that often, so... I'd say probably those two guys seem to be the ones I watch and enjoy the most. Zerx is the awesome... something like that. Asks, what is your favorite book or book series? Kind of cliche, I guess, but I guess I gotta go with Harry Potter. It's just the one book series that I just really followed religiously over the years and just really enjoyed the most. So my favorite book out of that series is probably Chamber of Secrets, I'd say. Second question: Team Pie or Team Cake? I guess I gotta go with Cake on that one. I'm not a big pie person. I don't know. It just kind of makes me sick. AshDude97 asks, are you afraid of the dark? Oh, yeah. Kind of. I'm more afraid of the unknown, I would say. You know. MarioMaster110 asks, what is your favorite Sonic game? That would have to be Sonic 2. Absent Mustachio asks, what is your favorite video game system? Probably the N64. Can't remember if I answered that, but... Second question. What would you do if you somehow lost your save file for a game you were Let's Playing in the middle of... Okay. If I lost the save file in the middle of a game I was Let's Playing... Well, that's actually happened before. So... I guess I would just have to play up to where I left off. Certain games, you know, would be horrible if that happened to... but with a game like for example Ocarina of Time, the good thing about that is you can create at least 3 files in that game, and you can for most Zelda games. So what I would do with that is I would always make a backup file. Like file 2 would be my main Let's Play file, and then file 3 would be like the backup in case something happened. So as long as you can create multiple files, you're usually okay. But with something like Banjo-Kazooie, that one was really risky because not only can you not make a backup file, but once you do something in the game, it's permanent. So if for some reason it didn't record my footage, I was pretty much screwed. So anyway. Zach Ruo Wrath asks, if you could be in GoldenEye 007 for the N64, who would you be? probably Trevelyan, just because he was so invincible. Well, I guess, according to the movie, Boris Kreshenko is invincible. I'm invincible! But yeah, Trevelyan, man, you could practically shoot him in the eyeball and he'd barely flinch, so... Yeah, I guess I gotta go with Trevelyan. Second question, has anyone ever called you goth, emo, punk, etc.? I don't think so, just because I don't think I've ever really demonstrated any of those traits, so... I don't think so, at least. Marianne2573 asks, who eats the most, Yoshi or Kirby? It's a pretty tough question, actually. I don't know. Might have to give them a tie on that one. I don't know. They seem to eat equally. I don't know. Atomic1Up asks, is it hard to be a zebra? Well, not so much. You just gotta watch out for those lions and watch out for the occasional poacher. But other than that, it's not too difficult, and it puts food on the table, so... Zykeb Zevrelev. God, you guys are torturing me with your usernames here. If you were stranded in an 30,000 millimeter deep pit that was slowly filling up with fermented olive oil, with nothing but a 3.2 meter piece of rope, half a bucket, the other half of the bucket, 7 zebras, a water bottle completely filled with whole white wheat flour, and a snowman, what would you do to escape? Die. I would just die. Or I would believe that I can escape. And then I would be able to escape, right? Second question, what is the statistical likelihood of you ever actually finding yourself in that situation? Probably 47. But the thing is, 67.8% of all statistics are just made up at the top of your head, so... Anyway... BlackMark10 asks, what is your... I already answered that one. Second question, let's say that a cat, a person, and a banana were all in a burning building with 5 floors. Now, ignoring that, there is also a fire hose next to you. But it can only stop one floor from burning and wouldn't affect the others. What would you do to stop the burning building and save the cat, person, and banana? You probably won't answer that second one. Well, yeah, I'll totally answer that second one. Tot Matt Lars asks, how long do you think it will take to answer all these questions? And okay, let me go back to the other guy. Well, I'm a big cat person, so I gotta try my best to save the cat, so... I don't know. I would just go after the cat, even if I had to risk my life to save it. Tot Matt Lars asks, how long do you think it will take to answer all these questions in number of videos? 723. What color is it on the bus that is beeping outside your window? There's no bus beeping outside my window right now, but it's usually yellow. The one that usually tends to do that, so... excuse me if I misspelled anything, I come from Sweden, so English is not my strong suit. Believe me, pal, you speak a lot better English than most people here in America, I can assure you. We live in a big world of R, U, and, you know, using the letter R and the letter U, and going to the mall using the number 2. I mean, believe me, pal, you've got a lot better English than most people here in America, so be blessed, man. Girl Power for the Win 1 asks, who's the most annoying, Navi, Tattle, or Kapora Gabora? All these annoying character questions. I guess Navi. I don't really find Tattle to be all that annoying. Probably Navi, I guess, out of those three. If you could date any character from the Legend of Zelda series, who would you choose? Oh god, that's gonna put me in that category of creepy internet people that, you know, draw pictures of these characters and stuff. Well, I can't pick Saria because she never grows up. I guess let's go with adult Melon, because she's, she's an innocent little ranch girl, and she, you know, she likes singing, and I don't know. Seems like she has a great personality, so let's go with adult Melon. H. Venoms asks, what do you think of the original Dragon Ball series? I think absolutely nothing of the original Dragon Ball series, because I never watched it. Sexy Sixy asks, you have some of the best edits I've seen on a Let's Play. Well, you haven't watched very many Let's Plays then, but thank you. I'd like to know what genre is your favorite to play on your own time, and what would be your favorite to Let's Play. Definitely platformers and adventure games, epic journeys, things of that sort. Lomani57 asked, do you prefer Mac or PC and why? I use a PC just because it's what I've always used growing up. I don't really have anything against Mac or anything like that. It's just not what I use, so. ZeldaGirl71 asks, do you love me? Just a little bit. Have you ever played a Persona game? No, I haven't. I actually never even heard of those games until relatively recently, so. Banjo-Kazooie Fan for Life asks, do you want Nintendo to make a new Mario Party game? I mean, I'm not really losing sleep over it. I mean, if they decide to do that, that's great. You know, I'm sure it'll be really pleasing to a lot of the Mario Party fans. You know, all 12 of them. you know, I mean, it doesn't seem incredibly likely, because, you know, with stuff like Wii Party and the Mario Party games, just, they don't really seem all that successful to me to begin with. I mean, maybe I'm entirely incorrect about that, but every time the Mario Party games come out, they just seem to be kind of pushed under the mat, and people don't seem to care about them all that much, so. Fixing a burp. Oh, they went away. Okay. Second question, so, yeah, I mean, if they do that, that's cool, but, I mean, I don't go to bed praying every night that they make a new Mario Party game. If they do, they do, but. Second question, will you be buying a Nintendo 3DS? I can't say yet, you know. I need to know more about how successful it is, and how great it is, and if it's worth it, and all that good stuff. But it's not out yet, so I don't know. Mr. Dangsky1 asks, which Zelda dungeon do you hate the most? Oh my god, man, I hate the Water Temple. No, that's the cliche answer, but I really don't hate the Water Temple as much as most people do. Just at the top of my head, I can't even remember the name of it, but it's the dungeon in Link to the Past that's in the Lost Woods, where you get the Fire Rod, and you have to fight that moth guy. I don't know, I never liked that dungeon. It never felt like a dungeon, because it's just, all the areas are just so scattered in the woods that it, I don't know, it just feels like a bunch of rooms. It doesn't even feel like a dungeon, and I don't know, that boss is just ridiculously hard, and it's just so hard to keep up with what rooms you've been in already, and which ones you haven't, and you have, like, the Gibdos and the Wallmasters, and I don't know, I just never cared for that dungeon. So probably that one at the top of my head. Cryovert asks, could I do an interview with you on my channel? Sorry, but no, I don't do random interviews with just random people who say, hey, can I interview you? I mean, if I did one random interview with somebody I don't know all that well, then eventually I'm going to have to do 50 others, so, sorry. Sugar, or Super Sugar the sugar. Ask, will you sing me happy birthday? I would, but that would make children cry and that would make windows shatter, so. Anyway. Monolithic Baby asks, which Pokemon would you like to have as a pet? Well, a lot of the really cool Pokemon, as cool as they are, they're not really fitting as pets. You know, like, I think Dragonite would be really cool, but he wouldn't really be much of a pet, you know? He's not like, he couldn't really hang out in your house or, you know, eat any of the food you feed him or anything like that. He would just, Dragonite's the kind of Pokemon that has to be exploring the world. You can't really, like, just keep him in your backyard and stuff, so. I guess just, like, in your house, petting, feeding kind of Pokemon. I guess Vulpix, just because he's my favorite. Ninetales would be another really cool one. Growlithe would be a good one as well. Yeah, I guess those. Brain Juke, I guess. It's like Brain Juice minus the E. Says, ask, favorite video game villain? Might have to go with Grunny on that one, just because she's, for me, she's like one of the most entertaining villains. Let's see, Time Fort Haunted, got it. Asks, what do you think of the Time Splitters franchise, and if we'll ever see a fourth installment? I think nothing of it, because I've never played that game. I know, like, nothing about that series. That name sounds familiar, but that's about as much as I know about it, so. Will we ever see a fourth installment? I know even less than you do, buddy, so, sorry. Let's see, Garland41 asks, have you ever played the game The Legend of Dragoon? Not only have I not played it, I didn't even know that game existed until relatively recently. I had never even heard of it before, actually. Maybe I've been living under a rock or something, but. How do you plan to answer all the questions you get? One day at a time. Psycho Jinjo asks, will you ever go back and play Banjo-Kazooie? I don't know if you mean just play it, like, in my own leisure. Well, yeah, definitely. I mean, I always replay Banjo-Kazooie at least, like, once a year. And, will you make me a bagel? Maybe later. Maybe sometime this week. Except, I can't do it any time between Sunday and Saturday, though. So, any other day, though, would be fine. Homshiba asks, is there any chance you would play Fear, its sequel, or any game like them? From what I've seen, probably not. It just doesn't seem like my kind of Let's Play territory, but sorry. You have a swear word in your username. These people are trying to get me to swear. Dadgummit. The username is Heartless BITCH and the number is 88, so Heartless Female Dog 88 ask, if you had the opportunity to recreate any video game that would make it, say, more interesting, which one would you recreate? I guess I'd take Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts and I would make the characters actually look cute and likable like they were supposed to look, instead of making Banjo look like this creepy hillbilly. Yeah. I don't know if that's a good game or not, but I mean, I'm sorry, I couldn't get over how ridiculous Banjo looked in that game. I couldn't understand why they went from cute, lovable teddy bear Banjo to the weird-looking, creepy hillbilly-looking thing. I don't know who looked at the original artwork of Banjo, the cute teddy bear looking bear, and said, let's make him look like this, the hillbilly thing. So, I guess I would do that. I would change the looks of those characters. AssassinMan13 asks, would you do a dual commentary with me? Back to what I said with the other person, I don't do co-commentary and stuff with people who I barely know. And, you know, I mean, I mean, do you have any idea how awkward that would be if you're trying to do dual commentary with someone you've, like, never even spoken two words to before? I mean, they wouldn't make very good videos. They would just... We barely know each other, you know? So, sorry. The Arbiter 10 asks, if you could live anywhere in the world, where would you live? Well, I'm kind of happy living where I do, but I guess another place... Well, I guess maybe Canada, just because I've got a few internet buddies that live up there, and I don't know, it just seems like a nice place to live. I guess, I'm sure a lot of my Canadian audience will go like, no, you don't want to live here, man, it's got this and this and this and blah blah blah, but I don't know. With the internet buddies that I do have that live in Canada, the buddies from Canada, I don't know, it just seems like a nice place to live, so. I don't know. Plus, they have free healthcare, so. Infertennis23. Oh, wait, sorry. I didn't answer the second question. Arbiter10's second question is Spider-Man or Batman? Well, that's tough, because I've always kind of related to Spider-Man a little bit more, because he's more like, you know, he was kind of a nerdy guy who was kind of sort of a pushover, and he sort of rose to the top and became Spider-Man, whereas Batman just kind of became Batman because his parents were rich and he got a bunch of money that they left behind. So I kind of relate to Spider-Man a little bit more, but Batman's just so much cooler. I'm sorry. So he's just so much cooler. I gotta go with Batman. Sorry. Sorry, Peter. Infertennis23 asks, how much ramen do you eat in a week? So, ramen noodles, I don't really eat them all that much, so, and if I do, it's usually probably like once in that particular week, so. Dr. Mario 711 asks, what bagel does the recap guy like? He seems like a pretty simplistic guy, so, he probably just likes regular bagels like I do. Second question, if the recap guy was to recap one event, what would it be? How about he just recaps life? Let's go with that. You know, the end of the world, he just recaps everything that's happened. Let's go with that. Cougar888 asks, have you ever played Fire Emblem? No. I also don't really know much about those games either. I've looked into them a little bit, but I haven't played them either. Sorry. Second question, do you like the Sonic games? I like the early Sonic games, the ones I've played, which... Sonic 1 through Sonic Knuckles, and then I've played a little bit of Adventure, and that was alright, I guess. It's mostly those. The Entertainer 1995 asks, what do you know about politics, Mr. Anderson? I know very little about politics, Mr. Anderson. Hyperboy2164 asks, Wii, PS3, or Xbox 360? Well, the only one of those three systems that I have is the Wii, so I guess I gotta go with it. NuberTuber1 asks, do you have any other... Well, I answered that one. Will you ever do a Let's Play on Zelda Skyward Sword when it comes out sometime this year? That is, if it comes out this year. I can't say, because I can never say if I'll do a Let's Play of a game when it's not even out yet. And I encourage people to do the same. I see people out there who talk about eventually, like, yeah, I'm going to do a Let's Play of Skyward Sword, but the thing is, I mean... The game's not even out yet. I mean, how do you even know you'll want to do a Let's Play of Skyward Sword? I mean, how do you even know the game will really be all that suitable for a Let's Play? I mean, granted, it is just a Zelda game, but still, you don't want to commit yourself to something when you don't even really know anything about the game, pretty much. All you really know at this point is that it's a Zelda game, you know? I mean, you don't know how great the game's going to be. I mean, who knows, you know? Granted, I've never played a bad Zelda game, but Zelda CDI doesn't count. Yeah, but you know, I think people need to hold off on that. I don't think they need to build the hopes up of their subscribers too much by saying they'll let's play something when they don't even know how good the game's gonna be. Or, and the other thing about Skyward Sword is that one thing I'm curious about is that apparently you're gonna be using like the Wiimote as the sword. I'm curious as to how that's going to affect people when they're trying to do commentary, because I mean, not like it'll be impossible, but we'll, like, sitting there and trying to swing the Wiimote and talk in a headset, it sounds like it's going to be pretty difficult to do. I mean, not, like, impossible, but I don't know, to have a headset on, like, yeah, we're swinging the sword, I mean, I don't know, it just sounds a little uncomfortable, and I don't know. But, you know, the game's not even out yet, so we'll cross that bridge when we get to it.